Hello again, I am Blunty. So, with the Switch, Nintendo are joining Xbox and PlayStation when it comes to making users pay an ongoing subscription fee for the use of most aspects of the device's functionality. With that comes many questions that, even now, just 18 days out from launch, Nintendo still have not answered. So we must wait until they at least talk about it before we can break it down for value and functionality. But a couple of things they have talked about is the lack of a web browser app, at least at launch. They did leave the window open for one to come later, perhaps, maybe. And rather more worryingly, it seems you will require a smartphone and a special Nintendo app just to use the most basic multiplayer online gaming functionality, like voice chat and lobbies. And while it might actually be nice to have your server browser and your lobby details and friends lists all sitting on a phone in a nice glanceable way, there are several big issues here. Number one, guess what? Now you're draining two of your device's batteries while you're gaming. Your phone's battery life is swallowed up by three major things: an active app, your screen turned on, and an active data connection. All three of these things are happening when you need to use your online functionality with your Switch, apparently. Why exactly, Nintendo, do I have to accept the killing of my phone's battery just for a few hours of gameplay online? It's dumb, it is very short-sighted, it is cumbersome, and frankly, entirely unnecessary. Why can't this stuff be done on the Switch itself? I very much hope this is just an option and not a requirement. But we don't know because Nintendo won't effing talk about it. But the dumbest aspect of this is voice chat. Aside from the other issues we just mentioned, the shitty requirement to use an even more expensive device with the Switch just to use online features inherent in every other console at a basic level, the inconvenience, the killing of yet another battery, right down to having to find somewhere just to put your phone where you can see it while you're using a Switch, then you have to put down your Switch and pick up your phone any and every time you want to interact with the online service, that's just, ugh. But here's the dumbest aspect. Okay, so you're using your phone for voice chat. You've come to terms with that. Fine. How does that work exactly? You're sitting there playing your Switch game. You're listening to your game either via your TV's sound system or your headphones, right? Same way you would on any other gaming device. So what now if you want to use voice chat? I can only imagine you have to somehow put a second pair of headphones on simultaneously to use voice chat, one that's coming from your phone. Or you have to have the TV sound constantly bleed through the single headset from your smartphone that you have to wear for voice chat. No one at Nintendo sees a problem with this? Really? Okay, so maybe the voice chat service on your phone then goes through the Wi-Fi or Bluetooth connection on your Switch, so you can then use just the Switch's own headset for voice chat and gaming simultaneously. But if so, what's the point of the smartphone at all if you're just feeding voice chat out to the smartphone and then back into the Switch? What? Is the Switch so gaspingly underpowered it can't handle that? Or is the Switch's operating system so incapable of multitasking it can't possibly run a VoIP server under a game? It is incredibly frustrating that Nintendo keep refusing just to talk about the goddamn online service properly and openly this close to launch. When interviewed by the Telegraph UK yesterday, Mr. Koizumi, Deputy General Manager of Nintendo Entertainment Planning Development, one of the few Nintendo suits that are being trotted around for various media interviews on the Switch lately, he was asked flat out, will the smartphone be integral to the online service beyond voice chat? And he answered, yes. We like to think as Switch as working very well together with smartphones, so we're basing quite a few plans surrounding that. One thing I am able to mention to you is you will be able to use your smart device to chat with people you are playing with online. Because this is a device almost everyone has, we think that there is a very broad reach for this service. So, he thinks that it's a great idea to pair up the Switch with a smartphone for online functionality because almost everyone has a smartphone. Hey dude, would you like to know what device 100% of Switch owners will have? A fucking Nintendo Switch. Several times now, we have seen quotes like this from Nintendo folk. Not once, however, has it been definitively stated if the smartphone voice chat is an option, and that voice chat can work with the Switch's own headset input, because the Switch does have a headset input, microphone and everything. Why is it there if you can't voice chat on the device? The issue of the web browser is also stupid. Now, I don't really mind that it's not there, personally speaking, except for one very vital issue. But for the most part, browsers on consoles have all been complete and total crap. They've been slow, they've all had terrible UIs and terrible support for modern web standards. I have literally never wanted to use them outside of testing for reviews and such. If I do need to look something up on the web while I'm gaming, I'll do so on my laptop, or indeed my phone. A device, by the way, that has, until it was needed for the few minutes of web browsing, has been sitting cool and quiet and idle in a low battery state, so it could be ready for use when I actually need it, not constantly burning down with some stupid app just to supplement vital missing features on a device that should have them inherent. The web browser is an essential thing for one reason. If you plan on using public Wi-Fi spots or even hotel Wi-Fi while you're traveling, it's very likely that more than a few Switch owners who do travel with it will want to connect it to hotel Wi-Fi. But you probably won't be able to do it with the Switch. Why? Because almost every time you connect to one of those hotspots, you'll be asked to sign in, or at the very least, agree to some kind of terms of use. Or you'll just be presented with some basic usage information you have to click through, like service time limits and such, before you can actually use the service. In every case, these are presented in a browser window, and without a browser, you'll be shit out of luck getting your Switch online at all while you're in your hotel room, winding down from the day, or trying to attach it to any kind of public Wi-Fi hotspot. You'll be shit out of luck downloading a simple software patch if you want to play some local co-op with friends who bought their own Switches somewhere with you. Maybe they updated their games before they left home. You didn't get a chance to patch your game yet, so now you're running differently patched versions of the same game, which will almost always mean that you're locked out of even local multiplayer. Now, maybe Nintendo are well aware of this, and maybe there is a basic web browser engine baked into the Switch's operating system that only triggers when you're connecting to Wi-Fi. Maybe not. Again, we don't know, because Nintendo are catastrophically bad at communicating with their own customers. It's infuriating. As for why they just don't put even a basic web browser on there to begin with, I mean, it can't be hard, right? They've done it before on several other devices. They know how to make a very basic, functional web browser. Just squirt one on there. Why not? Well, my guess is it has something to do with the fact that the 3DS web browser was the attack vector for more than one hack method to get unauthorized code running on the 3DS's system. The legally innocuous homebrew scene used this as well as the thing that makes Nintendo pucker their assholes and grind their teeth more than anything else on this entire planet. Game piracy. So given that on more than one occasion a web browser on one of their devices has been a window to piracy, it's not shocking to me that they're reticent to put a user-accessible web browser engine on their great grey hope, the Switch. But yeah, now, with less than 3 weeks remaining until launch day, I'd very much like to see a Nintendo Direct or two focused entirely on how online will work and how the phone app will work and precisely how essential it is in very, very specific terms, please. I'd also like a Direct on the subject of the Virtual Console. We know we're getting it because Nintendo have already confirmed that along with your subscription to the online services, you'll be allowed to play one NES Virtual Console port a month, and then they take it away from you. You don't get to hang on to it for the life of your subscription like you do with PS Plus. That's a whole nother rant. But in general, the Virtual Console is an area Nintendo have barely acknowledged in any but the most vaguest of ways. Again, frustrating. We shall see, though. For now, though, Nintendo's apparently clumsy approach to Switch's online functionality is very concerning. I would love to be wrong about all of this, but until they actually show their customers enough basic goddamn respect to talk about it, all we're left to do is sit here in concern and worry and conjecture and guess and extrapolate from what we do know. But thanks for watching. I am Blunty, and I will catch you next time.